And in class, and now we begin with the new chapter, Key Elements of a Democracy. Now, first we'll take up the term democratic. Now, what is democratic? That means the government in which people have the power to elect their representatives. They cast their vote through elections. They elect a person and they appoint that particular person or the government to look after the affairs of a country. So that means democracy. Democracy means the government which is running for the people, by the people, and it is appointed by the people of the people. Now, government here means any organization which looks after the working. Okay. Now, key elements. Key means the basic. What are the keys? What are the basic things? Elements. That means which formulas it uses. So basically, key elements of a democratic government means the basic things which are followed in a democratic form of government to rule a particular country or a state. Okay, so now we begin. Since your childhood, you must have seen the pomp and splendor of an election campaign. Most of the time during elections, parents and elders discuss politics and the possibility of certain candidates and parties winning or losing elections. You must have also seen leaders addressing election meetings and canvassing with folded hands on cars and jeeps, distributing pamphlets and leaflets. Indeed, an election is a festival to celebrate democracy. So now, a beautiful beginning of a chapter where they tell you that as a kid, you all must have seen at the time of election, the elders at home, your parents maybe, everybody is discussing about elections, about a representative, about a particular party which they will give vote to. And there's a constant discussion in the house about which party to be given election, elected, and to be given vote, and which leader is good, which leader is bad. A literal sense of politics is discussed at every level in that. Whatever knowledge they have, every member who is elder merely gives his view. Then they are asking in this paragraph that you as children also must have seen the leaders on jeeps and in open jeeps and cars, etc., with their folded hands and with garlands, making rallies, spreading pamphlets, etc., to make the people aware and to cast their, they compel people, they request people to vote for their particular party and appoint them as their leader. Now, this is a festival in a democracy. That means election, they call it a festival for democracy. Now, why is it a festival? Because it is for the good of the people. If I do not go and cast my vote, that means I am deprived of electing a person. So every vote makes a difference and all should cast their votes. Next, elections. Elections are a very heart and soul of a democratic polity. Let us learn by example how the non-white people in South Africa struggled for decades and sacrificed their lives to secure the rights to particular in elections. Now here they are giving you a beautiful example. They are saying that elections have been a major issue for any country. Now election, very simple, is a means in a country where everyone has a right to appoint a leader. Now supposing I am 18 plus, my age is 18 plus, so I have a right to vote. But if I am lazy on the day of election, I do not go and cast my vote. A single vote also matters. Supposing people like me, if 10,000 people also like me do not go to cast a vote, It's going to make a difference. Just thinking that I am the only one who's not going, so what difference it will make? Every vote is precious. All should use their voting rights. Now, what and how important election is, they have taken it through an example of the non-whites in South Africa. Now, non-whites means the black people. We do not use this term. Why? Because it is very offending to mention any skin color on basis of that we do elections. Now, in South Africa, there were people who were non-white. That means they were not fair in color. Now, those people were not allowed to vote. And it had been for ages and decades that these people were wanting the right to vote. Only the white people in South Africa were given the right to vote, which was very wrong. So now they say that there was a long battle fought in South Africa. They had to struggle a lot to take up a stand for the non-whites. They sacrificed their lives to secure this right to participate in the election. Then they talk of a new term. And listen to this new term very carefully, because you are going to read it for the first time. And the word is apartheid. Now, what does this mean? Apartheid means to separate somebody on the basis of color and caste. That means apartheid means ki aap kisi ko rok rahe hain, ki aap usko alag kar diya, ki nahi aap vote nahi daloge, kyunki aap gore nahi ho. क्योंकि आप अमीर नहीं हो, क्योंकि आप कास्ट को बिलोंग करते हो. नाउ सेपरेटिंग अ ग्रुप ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अ स्किन कलर वाज अ वेरी बैड आइडिया फॉलोड इन साउथ अफ्रीका स्पेशली कॉल्ड अपार्थाइड. लेट अस रीड अबाउट इट. साउथ अफ्रीकन पीपल वर डिवाइडेड इनटू व्हाइट, ब्लैक, इंडियन एंड कलर्ड रेसेस. Now, why Indian? Because some Indians were also living there. As per the law of the land, these races were not allowed to mingle with each other, to live near each other, or even use common facilities. Now, if you remember, even this was happening in India earlier. People were demarcated according to their basis of custom, caste, creed, and color. And this is what was happening in South Africa too. The non-whites and Indians and the colored people. Now, colored people doesn't mean that they were colorful. It means who had a little lesser fair complexion. So they were not allowed to vote. Only the whites, the gore log, the Britishers, the English people, who had occupied South Africa, just as Britishers had occupied India, they had also occupied South Africa, and they were ruling there. So only the rulers, basically the whites, were allowed to vote, and this was not regarded. There were revolts there. So did you know, during the apartheid era, South Africa was banned from playing international cricket. Now, South Africa, because it had black team members also in it, they were not allowed to play cricket in the international level. So they were deprived of it. South Africa was governed by apartheid law. That means separation on the basis of race. The minority population of whites ruled the majority of people who were non-white. Now listen to this much very carefully. The whites, gore log, they were in minority. That means they were lesser in minor group. And in South Africa, it was the black people who were in it. That means there were more. Yet, the black people being larger in number, they were not allowed to vote. They were not given the right to. And apartheid laws were followed. That means discrimination on the basis of color was, and only the white group of section, which was a small in number, only those people, The whites dominated all walks of life. The non-whites led an inferior and miserable life. There were separate hospitals, ambulances for white and non-white people. There were separate business buses, trains, even buses stops. Non-whites were not allowed to vote. The most fertile and irrigated lands were reserved for white people. The blacks and colored people had to cultivate infertile, barren, and marshy lands. The principle underlying all these discriminations was whites were by birth superior to color to the colored people. The blacks were forced to learn the Afrikaans, the language of the whites, at schools. The blacks had natural affinity for their mother tongue, Zulu. So this is another demarcated paragraph that tells you that the white people who were lesser in number, they dominated in every part of life. And the white and the non-white, they had separate buses and speak around. There were ambulances. They had that only the
ma'am, your voice
white,
is not
they would carry on. And then
ma'am, your voice is lagging.
Just check whether my mic is on. Okay, now are you getting it? Are you getting it now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So now they also tell you that the area for cultivation, the white of your mic.
Ma'am, your voice is lagging. Yes, ma'am, your voice is lagging again. Ma'am, your voice is lagging.
To cultivate, whereas the non-whites were given the input. Okay.
Mom, your voice is not coming.
Mom, your voice is not coming.
Is it? Should I can talk about the fertile? Okay. I will.